Okay, so we're going to talk about noises. Specifically, a clunk. That's what the customer's complaint is. Basically, so what they're complaining about is when they go from park to drive on an incline or a decline, that it clunks. I'm going to tell you right now, it's normal, and I will explain why. So right now, I'm in an incline, maybe about 10 to 15 degrees. My foot is slightly applied on the brake. I'm in park, so now I'm going to go to drive. So there's that clunk. Now, if I put it in park while my foot is firmly applied onto the brake, so I'm going back to park and I'm going to apply the parking brake. Okay, now I'm going to let my foot off. Now I'm going to do the same thing, but with a few extra different steps. So first, apply my foot on the brake. I'm going to disengage the parking brake. Then I'm going to go to drive. No clunk. So now I'm going to explain why.
So if you take a look at my beautiful artwork. So basically what we have here is something, it's a gear. I can't remember the exact word of it, but it sits on the tail end of most automatic transmissions. What we have here, this is a park paw. Now they call it a park paw because it rides along on a rod and it represents what looks like to be a paw of an animal. So whenever an automatic transmission is put into park, this park paw will actually sit into the gear and hold the transmission in place, preventing the vehicle from rolling when it is in park. This gear here will rotate at all times when the transmission is moving. So to eliminate that clunk, you are basically using the parking brake to hold the vehicle in place, and this park paw is going to sit maybe a little bit of clearance in between the gears as it sits. Now, sometimes when you put the vehicle into park and you just let it roll forward, that park paw is going to actually come in contact with this gear. And this gear is going to want to constantly rotate because the wheels are spinning. So the driveline's spinning with the transmission. So, like I said, to eliminate that, we're going to use the parking brake to hold the vehicle in place instead of having the park paw. Regardless, when you go into park, the park paw is always going to be engaged. The park paw is going to ride along on a rod that's actually going to be a part of the shifter mechanism. Either drive-by-wire or it's a drive-by, it's either a drive-by-wire or it's a drive-by cable. Now, a cable, it's going to ride on to where the shifter bushing attaches to the selector. And the selector is what actually moves the transmission into whatever engagement you want to do, from reverse to park, park to drive.
Now, I've had success with this in most automatic transmissions, not just Dodges and Chrysler products and anything else. Anything that I'm aware of that has an automatic transmission, you can relieve the tension off a park paw. Now, in the position that I'm in right now, if I remember correctly, I'm in that roll state, which is where the park paw is riding along the gear itself. So if I were to go into drive, it's going to clunk. Oh, maybe not. Okay, so let's see if we can do that. So I'm going to go into park. I'm on that incline. The car will slightly roll and then jerk back and forth because that gear, I believe it's a sprag gear, will bounce against the park paw. There's going to be a little bit of a spring tension there. So I'm going to go into drive. There's the clunk. Now to eliminate that, firmly apply the brake. Apply the parking brake while you're in drive. Go to park. The vehicle should not move. It might move like a little bit, but not too much. That's just enough so the wheels can actually engage in that drum and hat assembly on the brakes and hold the vehicle in place. It's kind of relieving the tension off the park paw. So again, I'm going to take off the parking brake, foot still applied, going to drive, no bump or clunk. Now let's go to a higher incline and you could see that it's going to be a much more violent jump. Okay, so right now I'm in a much higher incline. So I'm going to go to park. I'm going to let it roll back. And now I'm going to go into drive. It's really hard to do with my left hand. So there's a harder clunk because there's much more tension on that gear that I was talking about that sits on the tail housing. And the park paw is releasing and that gear is finally getting a chance to move. So it might have some little contact with the park paw. Don't worry, it's not horrible. But if you run into this situation where you don't want it to happen on a hill, it's going to be the same thing. You're going to firmly apply the brake on the floor, apply the parking brake while you're in drive, go to park. And the vehicle should slightly move, not a whole lot, not that movement back and forth when you're sitting in park. And this should relieve that clunk if it's annoying. I mean, it's completely normal. It's not causing any kind of damage. So we're going to firmly apply the brake, disengage the parking brake, go into drive. No clunk. So I'm just trying to basically say this is a normal operation if you ever run into this problem, that you're going from park to drive and you feel a massive clunk, especially when you're on an incline. It's completely normal because remember that park paw needs to come off so the transmission can move. Not saying that this gear is sole purpose is to move the transmission. This gear's sole purpose is so the park paw has something to put into place so it can hold the transmission in place, preventing the vehicle from rolling. Anyway, I hope this helps. That's pretty much all I got. Thank you.